Sensor sensitivity. Expo. Max rates. Sensor sensitivity. Third time lucky. In this video, I'm going to give you a quick simplified breakdown of what they mean, and I'll be testing some new rates on the DJI Avata 2 and seeing how I get on. Right, hello and welcome to another episode of FPV OE. My name's Emmanuel. So before I dive into the explanation of what each of those are, if you saw my last video, if I know how, I'll stick a card up somewhere here linking to it. You saw that I've been using the sim and I took the DJI Avata 2 out for one of my first test flights with it since I've been using the sim. While I was flying, it went really well, but I felt like it wasn't operating exactly as I thought it would do, especially when I was trying to do an orbit. When I was doing orbits in the sim, I was nailing them and I was doing really, really well, but when it came to doing them in real life, I just could not nail it with the Avata. So this got me to thinking, could it possibly be the rates? So obviously the rates I've been using in the sim are different to what I've been using on the Avata. So I'm now going to copy the rates over that I've been using on the sim, but I'm hoping it will make it a bit easier for me to use and basically perform the orbit I was trying to do last time. So what do they mean? I'll start with center sensitivity. So basically what this means is if you have it at zero, your sticks will feel the movement and translate it to the drone at the very center of the stick. So the moment you start to move it, that will translate to the drone. If you increase it slightly, it means you have a little bit of wiggle room before those movements are kind of really translated to the drone. It almost kind of numbs it down a bit. So that brings me on to max rates. So what is the max rate? That is basically the degree. So when you set a max rate, you're setting the degree that your drone will flip if you had the yaw or pitch or roll to 100% in 1 second. So if you set it to 360, that means in 1 second, if you were putting 100% input, it would rotate 360 degrees. So obviously the higher you have this, the faster the drone will roll and the more kind of snappy and acrobatic movements you can do with it. This then brings me on to Expo. So the best way I can think to describe Expo is to relate it to max rates. So if you basically have your Expo at zero and you had your roll at 360 on the max rate, if you put 100% in on the roll, that means it will do the 360 degrees. If you put 50% in, it's effectively going to be doing 50%. So you could say 180 of the max rate. What the Expo does is if you increase it, it kind of pushes this back and stops it from being a one for one. So it basically means that if you set your Expo to 0.5 and you were to put in maybe 50% input, it wouldn't actually be 50% it would be putting in to the roll. It would be maybe 30%. And it kind of changes that scale back so that you still have the 100%, but you have to move the stick further to reach those higher percentages. So that's what my understanding of these three things are. If you've got a better explanation or you have another way to describe it that might be better, please do let me know in the comments, because obviously I'm still learning myself, but that's what I've taken from it. Right, this now brings me on to moving over the rates from the sim onto my DJI Avata 2. So when I was looking at the rates, I had no idea what they meant on the sim at first because it was in beta flight. I did not realize that you had to change it to actual. So after a quick Google and a little lookup, I realized that there's the two different options of using it. So the DJI uses actual. So I switched it to actual on here and I saw what the rates were on the sim. So I've now transferred those rates over to my DJI Avata 2 and I'm now gonna take it out for a flight and see how I get on with it. Right, we are out here at Grafham Water. It is very windy, unfortunately. So it's probably not the best time to really try my new rates and to see if I can do a good orbit. I say it's really windy, so I've actually never really flown in windy conditions before, so this will be interesting. I'm going to take off anyway, and there's a water tower kind of like down there further down that I want to try and orbit, and that's what my plan is. We will see how it goes, because as I say, the wind is quite strong, so yeah, let's get up and let's see how it goes. Right, so we are set up. I'm going to start the motors and get us off into the air. I will quickly show you the rates I've copied over from the sim. So control, remote controller,
Again, an Expo. So these are the new rates that I've been using on the sim that I'm going to now try in real life and see how they go. So as I say, it's really windy. So I'm hoping it will be all right, but I'm going to go over here. This is my first time over water in full manual, so I'm feeling very nervous about this, especially as it's windy. But it's a beautiful day, so I thought to myself, this is the perfect place to come and try and get some filming done. You can see the water tower where I'm planning to head to, so I'm going to pick up the pace a bit. And I'm going to go straight into the orbit. That's my plan, I think. Oh gosh, have I got my little things up? I do, yes. I'm going to go straight into the orbit when I get there. I'm losing a bit of reception, which I'm surprised at, because I'm not that far away. But I guess it's purely because there's a bit of trees in the way. So yeah, so this is the water tower. I'm going to go straight into the orbit with the new rates and see if it will allow me to do a better job than I was doing last time. So here we go. Oh no, because I'm not going to go straight into the orbit. I'm going to go past it and then swing back into the orbit and see if I can do a better orbit than I was doing last time. So that didn't go that well either. I don't know if it's the wind. I'm going to whip it back round. Okay, so let's have a look. I'm going to take it into the orbit. I should probably be a bit further away. No, okay, fine. No, new attempt. I'm going to come in for a new line. This is what I think I need to do. Just get in with a new line for it and then come in. So I'm going to come in a bit faster, swing it round, and there we go. So there's my orbit with the new rates. Let me make sure I keep power on it. I'm getting closer than I wanted to. So yeah, I don't know why my orbits in with the Avata aren't working. I thought the new rates would help me because it's like the center sensitivity's been changed, and the Expo slightly. But I'm gonna try it again. But I say I just find it so much easier to do on the sim, as you saw on that video I showed earlier. But I can't seem to nail it with the Avata in real life. I say it's really windy today, so that might also be an aspect of why. But okay, hold on, that's no, it's not going anywhere near as I would have liked it to. I'm determined to crack this orbit because I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong with the Avata in real life. So let me come back. I'm going to go into it, because when I go into my orbits in the sim, I kind of fly into it and then turn around. So I'm going to go into it, kind of go past it, and then try and swing round into the orbit, and we'll see how we go. So if I go past, swing it round into it. Oh no, oh, it's really windy. I could feel the wind just then. The wind just blew me completely off course for that. So yeah. Okay, let me just try. I'm going to try and orbit from the distance, because I don't know the wind. I think it's way too windy. Look at this, the wind. I say I'm losing like kind of my reception, and the wind is really strong. I don't know if you can even hear me properly because of the wind. But yeah, this orbit is going terribly. This is really bad. I don't understand why I can't do the orbit. I'm going to have to come back out and try this again another day when there is no wind. Because as I say, it is not going well at all. I'm going to have one more pass at it because the battery is getting slightly low, I guess because it's fighting the wind as well. So I'm going to have one more pass at it and see if I can do an orbit. And no, I can't. And I think the wind is just too much. So I'm going to bring it back, just fly back, and probably could just come and land. I won't fly too much more here because, I say, of the wind. I wanted to try and test out some of the like ACRO and split S's and stuff like that. But as you can see, it's like you can see that warning in the corner there. It says high wind velocity. So the drone's struggling. I've got it almost at full power on quite high tilt. We're only hitting 44, whereas it should in reality be hitting about, so I don't know what, 60, 70 I think it hits. So yeah, so I'm going to bring it back in anyway and come and land, because it is not going well. So let me just hit the pause button and I'll bring it back down in normal mode. I'm tempted to get another battery out and go and try it again. So I might go and try another one just because I feel I can do better. Right, I'm gonna take back off. I'm not going to head out to do the orbit. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come over here and just do some flips and stuff. I've got the pause button ready to hit just in case, but just to show you the new rates of like turning and stuff like that, so you can see how much faster those rolls are than now that I've obviously upped the max rate on it. I'm going to try split S over here, so wish me luck as well, because I'm going to do it over the water, my first one. And that went all right. I'm really high up, as you can see, so I wasn't in too much danger or worry about doing it. I'm going to do another one. Okay, and they're going all right. Yeah, so split S is going all right with this. I say the orbit is the thing that's annoyed me the most because I can't seem to nail it. But I want to try and orbit something else if there's something around here. No, there's nothing really around here. Let me try and maybe do this tree. I'll just do an orbit of this tree, actually, if I can. No. I'm going to blame the wind because it's really windy. It's really windy out here today, and so it's blowing it around quite a bit. But all the other rates feel quite nice. The center sensitivity is obviously a bit better. Obviously, because I'm a thumb user, so it makes it a bit less twitchy in the middle. The rolls and stuff are all now super fast. Oh gosh, that was a bit of an overshot. But they now match what I was using in the sim, so it makes it a bit better. But I'll do a couple more split S's just to get a more cinematic kind of drop on the water. That was nice. That was nice, if I do say so myself. Yeah, no, it's really good. I think the battery's dropping even faster today just because of how windy it is. So the drone's obviously having to fight through it for its life to stay up there. Do another split S. Yeah, so now I'm enjoying it. The rates have made a slight difference. I say it's difficult to see if they've really made a huge difference because I'm using flying in a really windy day. So I can't really tell that much. But I'm happy with it. I'm going to keep trying it. I think it's going to be a case of just as well trial and error and fiddling around with the rates a bit to see what I prefer. But this will do for now, because like I say, I'll just stick with what I've been doing in the sim. But I just need to come out on another day when it's not so windy and try and nail that orbit. So that is the bit that's annoying me the most. The orbit, I just cannot seem to... Oh, that was close. I came in late on the power on that one. Okay, fine. Let me bring it back in. Let me bring it back in. I'll land. In fact, I'll fly till the battery's low, but I'll probably cut the video here and say and end it there. Right, hasn't been the test flight with the new rates I wanted. I say it's really, really windy today. I don't know if you can see it, but you can see on the drone on the screen like the high wind velocity. So it wasn't the best time to test it, but it was a nice day, so I thought I'd come and give it a try. I will test the rates more. I might tweak them. At the moment, I probably won't, but I'm going to stick with them as they are. Just carry on flying, and I'm going to keep trying for that orbit because I do not know why I can nail it in the sim, but I can't nail it in real life. So if you have any ideas why you think I'm not nailing it, let me know. And if you're enjoying the content and enjoying the videos, please remember to like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'll be notified when my next videos come out. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on FPV OE.